Hello everyone, this is Ningxi with Data Science Dojo. Today we're going to start introducing you to a very powerful tool in R called Dplyr that's widely used for data manipulation and analysis. It's going to make your data munging process that much more efficient and easier. We're going to start talking about how to set up Dplyr and also cover the data preparation process in this series. As an overview of this series, we're going to talk about why we use Dplyr and what it does. We'll also start introducing you to some basic functions that Dplyr can do, including arrange, group by, summarize, select, filter, intersect, and set diff. Through this series, you're going to learn how to arrange data, how to do group by aggregation, as well as how to subset columns and rows, and how to find overlapping and non-overlapping values from two different data sources. The goal of watching this Dplyr series is that you should be able to use the functions we introduced to perform basic data manipulation tasks at hand. You should also be able to, at a high level, start thinking about the data analysis as a process that you can divide and conquer into subgroups. So instead of looking at one massive data set as one standalone entity, after learning group by aggregation, you should start thinking about how to divide up the data you have into subparts and dissect it that way. It's only going to make your job easier. We're going to demonstrate how to use Dplyr while working with a real-world dataset from Kaggle on wine ratings. The goal of this Dplyr series is to get beginners up to speed quickly and help you guys select segments that you find most useful. So you don't have to watch every single video in the series. You could just pick and choose whatever segment you find most relevant to the task you have at hand. We don't have hard prerequisites for you prior to watching the series, but you should be able to have some familiarity with basic R syntax. You should be able to code very simple commands in R before watching the series, since learning how to use packages such as Dplyr and ggplot builds upon a foundation of understanding how the R programming language works. If you're not familiar with it, please check out our YouTube page. We have a whole series on introduction to R on our in our channel. So please go to that page and watch that series before watching the Dplyr series here. In this video, as part one of the series, we're going to demonstrate how to get RStudio, as well as the wine ratings dataset from Kaggle. We'll also walk you through how to install and load Dplyr and ggplot, including how to properly load foreign characters into RStudio. A little bit about myself, I started my data science journey after a career in finance because I wanted to learn more data-driven techniques. I create content for Data Science Dojo as well as teach part of our 5-day in-person bootcamp that we host around the world. These are tailored toward working professionals, and they're meant to get you up to speed and in order to apply data science techniques in your daily work immediately upon graduation. So I encourage you to check that out. I enjoy using data to uncover interesting and fun things in life. So as you can see, we're going to talk about wine ratings today. I hope you guys get a lot out of it. Okay, so now you know what to expect. Let's get right into it. First, we're going to show you how to download RStudio and R if you don't have that on your computer. Just go to Google and type in RStudio, and the first link that comes up should be the place where you can get it from. So I already typed this in my search bar. Come over here, click download RStudio. Just choose the first option, click download. Make sure that you also download R before RStudio, because RStudio is just an IDE that supports the underlying R language. So make sure you download both. Come over here to download R. Choose your respective operating system and go through the prompts. I'm gonna go back to the page for RStudio. So once you have downloaded R from CRAN, it's a network that supports the R programming language. You're going to come back to the RStudio page and choose your operating system and download the IDE. So for instance, for Mac, you click here and Windows here, so on and so forth. I already have it on my computer, so I'm not going to click through it, but you pretty much just hit return or enter continuously until you have that download on your computer. So once you have downloaded both R and RStudio, we're going to get our data set from Kaggle. So just go back to Google, type in wine ratings Kaggle, and that should be the first link that comes up. So clicking this link will take you to the Kaggle page where this data set resides. If you're interested, you can scroll down and just read about the background of the set, why this user decided to provide it here. Also shows you the different features that are in the set and some related links. But we're going to go to the data tab and choose the second option from the left-hand side toolbar and click download. I'm gonna rename it wine just because it's easier. Save and unzip the file. So because I'm going to load this into my RStudio later and I don't want to have to type in all these words, I'm just gonna rename this CSV file and just call it wine, making it easier for myself to type in RStudio later on. So once you have both RStudio and the dataset loaded, open up RStudio. Make sure to go into the directory where this dataset is saved. So for me, that's on my desktop. I'm gonna go to my desktop. And this is very important. Make sure to go over here, click more, and set as working directory. So this will make sure that your current working directory is set to where the data set is saved. So when we read the CSV into RStudio, the system will know where to find the set. Otherwise, it'll just be confused. So once I've done that, I'm going to create a new object. Let's just call it wine for simplicity. I'm going to set this object to the content of the CSV. And because I had renamed the dataset previously, now I can just do wine.csv instead of that whole long name that we started out with. Also make sure to set this parameter strings as factors to false, because otherwise RStudio will treat all the characters as factors, which we don't want since there are a lot of columns that contain text, different country names and tasting notes and different wineries names, and there's no need to treat them as factors. So setting strings as factors equals false makes sure that all the text is loaded as characters instead of factors. And also because of this, the nature of the set, go back to the Kaggle page. If you just play around and quickly browse the first 100 rows, you'll see that a lot of these wines are from European countries, and the foreign languages have different accents. So for instance here, so French, Spanish, Italian, etc. all have accents on certain letters. And if we don't do anything and just read the data set as is, it's going to mess up all these words that have accents. So we need to do something special here and pass another parameter and set it to encoding equals UTF-8. So this makes sure that all the characters are loaded correctly. So I'm gonna load that into my console. As you can see here, it means the data set is being loaded and now it's done. If we want to take a quick look at what this data set looks like, into view, make sure V is in uppercase. So do another quick scan of the data set we just loaded. And everything looks good. All the accents are imported correctly. This probably goes without saying, but this is a Dplyr video, so we're going to need to install Dplyr into our studio. We're also going to use ggplot to do some basic visualizations. So let's do install packages and just type in Dplyr in quotes. Also gonna install ggplot too. So once these two packages are loaded, we also need to call them explicitly. So use a library function, and this time around you don't need quotes because we already have these packages. If you go over here, you can see that these are available in our studio, but they are not loaded. There's no check mark here. So we're gonna actually call the library by using the library function. I'm gonna do the same thing for ggplot2. And now we're good to go. We'll also see that we have this weird extra column named X. So we're going to get rid of that momentarily. We also have this column named description that seems to be Sommelier's textual statements about how these wines taste. And because this tutorial is not going to focus on natural language processing, we will soon drop this column as well. So this is a fairly large data set. You can see over here, it has over 150,000 observations of 11 variables. And we're not going to use all the columns. So let's clean the set now. I will overwrite our original data frame by subsetting only the columns we want. So we can do, this means we want all the rows. And minus sign means we don't want these columns. The first column and the third. That was description, I believe. Now if we do view again, you can see that the weird X column and the description column have been removed. I hope that by watching today's video, you're able to get up and running with using Dplyr. In part two of this series, we're going to cover how to select and filter rows, as well as perform some basic visualizations with ggplot. You will see that ggplot and Dplyr often work seamlessly together to create neat data analysis and visualization results all in one. So thank you for watching and stay tuned for part two of this series.